We're honored to have Sarah Traylor with us, and we are honored to have you
talking
about your life with asthma.
Right.
And so tell us, I mean, how long have you had asthma? Obviously, you grew up in Australia. You married an American, so you're now here. You're on staff here at Faith Life Church. We're excited to have you here on board.
Thank you.
But tell us the history. I mean, about your asthma.
Okay, I'm 33. Yes, I'm saying my age on TV. But I was probably 2 years old, which is very young. When I first had my first symptoms, I was a toddler, my mom told me. And so at that age, they don't like to diagnose, so they just treat you. They give you nebulizers, like the breathing mask every 4 hours at my house. My mom would do that. So it was probably when I was five, though, they officially just said, yes, it's asthma. So those 3 years, though, I still was on a medication regime. So in the earlier years, when I was a toddler, it was the mask, and then when I got older, the inhalers.
Every 4 hours?
When I had a flare-up, it was every 4 hours, and then they'd get it under control. I would always have steroids to get it under control, and then I would go on twice a day, two puffs twice a day.
Every day?
Yes,
How often would it get out of control?
I had allergies, so it always flared up. I was allergic to everything as a child, so it would... I'd walk outside and I would flare up. I'd play with a cat, I would flare up. So my mom was actually, worked in a hospital. So she sometimes would just take me to work because she figured it was easier. She worked in the emergency room. They'd just put me on a cot in the emergency room and treat me there.
This is your memory of growing up. Is asthma.
I remember hospitals a lot. I grew up and I actually was a nurse because I was around hospitals so much. I was around nurses so much. But I was just in and out my childhood. I didn't get to enjoy a lot of things because I want to do stuff that my siblings would do, and then I wouldn't be able to breathe. So I ended up just sitting back and watching. And
so it's really debilitating.
It is. And it's not that. The thing is, the doctors would always say, first they would say, she's going to grow out of it, because children usually do. It's like, okay, she's going to grow out of it. But then I got older and I didn't grow out of it. So then it was just... Now, make sure you stick to this. If you are compliant with what we are telling you, you take these medications, you're going to be fine. And so just being compliant and taking the medications, but again, I would have flare-ups. So back to hospital for week-long stays and then discharged on steroids, which is just nasty. Doesn't make you feel good.
Does this happen every year? I mean, once you grew up, this happened every year?
It happened. And then when I got into my late teens and I just became more compliant and more aware of what triggered it, like if I had ice cream, the cold would trigger my airways to constrict. So I just avoided having like a thick shake or a milkshake, because I remember being out at the mall with my mom and she bought me a milkshake when I was a child, and the cold air constricted my airways and I was rushed off to hospital. So I was like, I just avoided things as I got older, and so...
Wow. So when you got older, did you still every day have to take medication?
Every
day. And what about what do you call it, the little thing?
Inhaler.
The
inhaler.
Yeah.
Every day?
Every day. Every day.
You used it every day.
Right. I had a rescue inhaler, the albuterol, and then a preventative. And so I took the preventative twice a day, and then if I was having a flare-up, I took the rescue inhaler as well. So that kind of, my whole childhood, I remember inhalers. I carried them with me. I slept with them under my pillow.
When we met you, you had all these things still going in your purse.
In my purse, one in the glove box of the car. My mom always had one. Just to make sure.
So that's really bondage. That's really...
It really was.
So what did God do? How did he bring this about that you're healed today? You're not using any of these things.
You know, it's not that I didn't believe God healed. I'd seen miracles. My mom, I grew up in church, and I remember being at a Kenneth Copeland convention in Australia, and I saw a man prayed for and get out of his wheelchair, and he pushed the wheelchair down the aisle and he'd been paralyzed. It's not that I didn't know God could heal, and it's not that I didn't believe he would heal me. And my mom would always take me down for altar calls and have the pastors pray for me, or the elders, and there's definitely, you know, it says to have the elders pray for you when you're sick, but it almost became a religious thing, like whoever new came to church, let's get you out there and they'll pray for you, and then that's going to be it.
So you were prayed for by lots of
people.
Oh
my goodness, I was prayed by some, you know, if I said names, you would know who they are.
What changed was
I was sitting, you were doing the Live Whole series, and you preached it over several weeks, and so I was listening, and just things that scriptures I'd heard as a child and knew were in the Bible, but they just started to mean more. And I said to God, okay. And there was testimonies, because hearing other people's stories was really helpful. And so I was just listening and I was taking notes furiously. And I was like, God, I just really know, like, this is going to be my time. But it's still in the back of my head. Like, I still was like, my faith wasn't quite there, because the facts were still screaming at me.
you had developed 30 years.
Right, it was habit.
Of this thing right. that you had to grab every day.
Right, it was like a security blanket yeah. to me. So if my husband, if we accidentally left the house, and then I'd be like, well, I know I have the one in the glove box, but what if that ran out? And so I'd make him turn around and go back and get me my other inhaler that I'd left in my other purse.
So you kind of live in fear
right.
that you're going to run out of something.
Fear there yeah. as well.
It's like you said, like a security blanket.
So, right. so you've been prayed for. Mm-hmm. You've heard that God heals.
Right.
You mentally believed God heals.
Right. I thought I was in faith many times that I was mm-hmm. getting prayed for. I was like, yes, I have faith. And they're like, do you have faith? Do you believe God heals? Absolutely, I believe. But still, the facts were still more what was talking to me. Mm-hmm. Because the doctors had always said, look, you're going to be fine. People live with asthma all over the world. Just take the medication and you will be fine. And so I just accepted that was going to be my normal for life.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
it's like, you know, I was a nurse. My mom worked in hospitals. So it was almost harder for me because it was yeah, like what the doctor yeah. said.
You've been conditioned from an early
Absolutely.
Age to believe
Absolutely.
What the doctor said.
Yeah.
So what did you hear yeah. in Live Whole that made the difference?
What clicked? When did it click?
It clicked when Amy got up to share her testimony.
That's our daughter who was healed of a massive tumor.
Right. That's the morning it actually clicked, but I'd gone through this whole series and hearing these testimonies. But that morning, something she said was that the doctors had told her that's her normal for her body. Mm-hmm. And instantly, I felt heat go through my body. I was shaking because I said, God, oh my goodness, Lord, I'm so sorry. I accepted the doctor's word over the word, over the Bible, what your word mm. says. And I knew what the scriptures were. And so I knew instantly where I'd gone wrong. Mm. And so I knew in that minute, my husband looked at me kind of like, don't make a scene, because I was like crying and I felt shaking and I was flushed. But I just knew that I knew that I knew that I was healed. And I didn't even know if there was going to be an altar call. And I was like, I don't even need to get prayed for. Maybe I should for the formality of it or something. But I just knew I was healed. So I was like, I don't care. I know I just received my healing. I repented to God, though, because I was like, I just really accepted. There's facts, but then there's the truth, what God says.
Okay, so that day.
So I faced the facts, but I was like, that's not my truth.
Yeah, so that day, what happened? What'd you do?
So I did get prayed for. Amy prayed for me. But I already knew I was healed. And I told my husband. I wasn't talking on the way home, which is not me. I'm a talker. And I was sitting there quietly processing, and he's like, honey, what on earth was going on? And I said, babe, I was healed. And he's like, okay, all right. And I was like, no, you don't understand. I was healed. And he's like, okay, I believe you. I was like, no, I know that I know that I know that I know that I was healed of asthma. And so I went home. I didn't take any medication that night. I didn't take any when I got up the next morning. But then I was making lunch for my boys. We were going to go to the zoo. And then the thought hit me. It was like it dropped in my head. You didn't take your medication. So I was like, split second, I started to panic, and instantly I had symptoms. Like instantly, I started
fear and symptoms.
Mm. So what did you do when you had symptoms start to hit you?
So my thought was, go get an inhaler. And I went, no, I know I was healed yesterday. So I went and got my Bible, and I cut out scrap pieces of paper, and I just started writing out every scripture I knew in the Bible on healing. And so I just started speaking them out loud. I mean, I was loud, because I was like, not that you have to say it out, you know, loud. I was loud. I was just
yes.
like, no, I know that by your stripes I was healed. That means I was already healed, because it was 2,000 years ago. I received
yes.
it yesterday. I am healed. So I just kept speaking those scriptures, and the symptoms left instantly.
And you replaced the inhaler with the scriptures in your purse.
Right. I had the scriptures,
yeah.
and I carried them with me for well, actually, I only just took them out and put in my Bible a few weeks ago, and that was two
yes.
years ago.
Sarah, you know, that's a fantastic story. And the part that catches my attention is you had to enforce it.
Right.
I want you to just talk to someone out there right now that's maybe in a situation, they've heard it before, they know that God heals, but I want you just to talk to them and encourage right. them that they can believe God for healing.
Right. Yeah, if you've been out there, I know what it's like when the symptoms are screaming at you and you've stood in faith and you believed you healed and woke up the next morning only to have symptoms. But you know what? When the symptoms are screaming, you have to make sure that God's word's louder. What's in your heart, that picture. I knew that I knew that I knew that I was healed. And so I clung to that. I talked to the enemy. I read scriptures. I read them out loud in my house. I just stood on what God had told me. And when the symptoms kept coming back, and then over time, within a month, they were completely gone. And that was 2 years ago this October, completely gone. Stand, face the facts. Yes, the symptoms were there, but you know what? God's word said I was already healed 2,000 years ago on the cross. And so I just encourage you, get the Live Whole series. Know the word, know what God says about you, that he wants you to live whole and that he wants you to just live an abundant life and to not be restricted by symptoms. And I just really encourage you just to really stand strong on what God's word says
Amen.
For you.
Amen. That's a good
Amen.
Word. We know we're just excited to be with you right now and encourage your faith. See you next time.
Today's special presentation of Live Free was brought to you in part by the Ford Financial Group and Lindsay Honda and Acura.
Hi, I'm Gary Cassie, and you will never fulfill your destiny until you fix your money thing. Visit GaryCassie.com and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below for more amazing weekly videos on fixing your money thing. And thanks for watching.